morning, everybody. Good morning, good morning, good morning, and welcome to the channel. This is Steve Callaway, Steve Callaway 1 on YouTube, and this is something different for me. This video at the top left over here, it's a newly released video, Bad Valentine official music video. I have not seen it before. I played the first few seconds and I realized I had not seen it before. So I thought, well, I know I guess I fit in the category of reactors in a way. I feel like I'm more of a commentator because I've seen most of the stuff that I put up, in most cases multiple times. But this one's new. It just came out yesterday. I haven't watched it. I just went and got it and put it on here and I said, you know what? Let's do an actual first-time reaction. Why not, right? So you guys are here. Anybody that's here with me for this good morning wake-up thing is let's share the experience, okay? Let's go ahead and watch Angelina with her brand-new, just out yesterday, Bad Valentine official music video.
Stood you up on Valentine, gave you no reason why. Decided I caught you off without a tear in my eye. I hit too high when I saw you on some table far too. I knew I'd never see the sun shine with you. I spent my night with the moon. I thought I told you I would miss a pure. I warned you are from the start. Roses are red and violets are blue. And you are a fool to try. Cause I'm a bad.
Well, I hope you guys like that. I know I sure did. I've seen this, you know, Angelina's put out several versions of this song, including some live performance and so on. And it's her original song, so I'm sure she's excited to have it out there for her fans and the audience. So, yeah, it's an interesting video. It's, you know, you don't, not the typical video you see. But it certainly is, it keeps the vintage Mustang, I think that is, and then the old middle of nowhere kind of run down environment out there. It's just interesting the way she put this together. Well, actually, Toby Gadd, I guess, directed it according to the credits at the end. So I'm sure they collaborated on the ideas of what to do and how to do it. Angelina's quite creative, I think, in so many ways. So yeah, that was a really great video. I can see myself watching it over and over again on a loop. Why not? Not to mention, you know, Angelina, of course, her voice. It's her song, her voice, her message. And it's there's no one like Angelina. There really isn't. You know, there's a lot of really, really, really talented and great singers out there, but there's nobody like Angelina. That's, to me, you know, this is a good morning wake-up, so I just play a variety of things. They're pretty much all have something to do with Angelina, but it's a variety of things. And you'll see that in the next, actually, the next three clips that I have here. There's full song. Then there's a almost a mini documentary on the Los Angeles concert that was held recently on September 20th. And then the last one, there's no talking. It's just Angelina with some background music. So, yeah, you know, why do I do this? Why do I do this channel? Why do I spend my time making these videos? Don't I have something better to do? Go get a job. I got a job. Why they still keep me? Because I'm always late to work because I'm making these videos. And I get up early to get them done, and I still don't get them done. I still get late to work all the time. Well, whatever. We're almost done. We're down to 8 boats, and then we'll be done for the season. That's starting with over somewhere in the mid-550s, I think, around there, give or take almost 600 is what I was told. Boats that we start with in the beginning of the fall to put away, clean, shrink wrap, and all that. But we're down to 8 boats. And then we usually finish up with everything that we have to do just before Thanksgiving. Looks like we're right on target to get done, maybe a little early even. And then I can spend more time making videos. So anyway, thanks for watching. Thanks for joining me to watch that video for the first time. I hope you enjoyed it. And let's move on to the next song. We've got... let's do this one next. This one is, I think, If I Were a Boy in this church that she's been playing in, singing in. And it has some really great acoustics. So let's go ahead and listen to that.
If I were a boy, even just for a day, I'd roll out of bed in the morning, thrown what I wanted and go. Drink beer with the guys and chase after girls. I could kill with who I wanted and I never get confronted for it, cause they stick up for me. If I were a boy, I think I could understand how it feels to love a girl. I swear I'd be a better man. I listen to her, cause I know I'm with her. When you lose the one you want, cause it's taking you for granted, and everything you had got destroyed. If I
were a boy, I would turn up my phone, tell everyone it's broken, so they think that I was sleeping alone. I put myself first and make the rules as I go. I know that she'd be faithful, waiting for me to come home, to come home. If I were a bird, I think I could understand how it feels to love a girl. I swear.
That was good.
That felt really good. Musically, it was really good.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so that was the If I Were a Boy cover that Toby Gad originally wrote for... Beyonce, right? And she to put it out, it was about 8, 9, 10 years ago, something like that. And then when he heard, when Toby Gad heard Angelina sing, he thought she probably should sing this song. I think it's made for her, you know. And turns out he was pretty much right. So let's go on. This next one here is a little mini documentary about a little bit of backstage stuff. In this picture, you can see over here where my cursor is to Angelina's right, and it would be our left, the blonde-haired lady. That's Angelina's mom, Sarah. And in several spots here, you'll see Grandma Mary in there, too. So Angelina, wherever she goes and performs, her whole family is there in support of her. And that's great to see, right? So let us go ahead and watch this one.
Like this show, since it's in LA, it's really gonna boost her like popularity like a lot.
We're excited to see Angelina. Where do you see her being in like 10 years from now? with a Nobel Prize.
And her Bohemian Rhapsody popped up. I watched it and I was mesmerized. And then I immediately looked up anything else that she had. My next video was I Put a Spell on You, and I was hooked.
I stumbled across a YouTube video back around March of 2020. So the pandemic was just starting. And I was absolutely floored and couldn't believe what my ears were hearing by watching the first video of her. And I became a huge fan.
This is my third Angelina Jolie concert. I found her back in 2020 during the COVID lockdown. And I was like, when I saw the Bohemian Rhapsody, I was in tears. I watched it like 30 times in a row. Then I went down the rabbit hole like everybody else.
I'm so happy. Her voice and her vibes and energy. So I feel I fly when she sings. And she's very special. She's a special talent.
I have kidney dialysis, and she saved my life.
Angelina and Toby's brand new single, Bad Valentine, is available today. We implore you, we beg you, please call all your radio stations. Listen, stream it, request it, do everything you can. Let's get a good tour for Angelina here. Ladies and gentlemen, it's the 10th anniversary since she won Norway's Got Talent. Finalist on Golden Buzzer was on America's Got Talent. Brand new single coming out today. Let's please, please put your hands together. Give it up. Give it everything you've got. Show some love for Angelina Jordan.
Give you no reason why. Decided I caught you off without a tear in my eye. Saw you on some table far too. I knew I'd never see the sunshine with you, so I spent my night with the moon. Valentine, I'm a bad Valentine.
that you're like, you're very, in a very, very special place in my heart. So, thank you.
Hard to talk after that one. Now it brings back memories of the concert because I was there. But, you know, her, Angelina's personality and makeup is such that, she makes this video and, says how much she appreciates her fans coming. Yeah, you keep having shows, Angelina, we'll keep coming. You know, and we'll be adding more people to the your fan base, which you call your angels. And that's what we call ourselves too, by the way. In case you didn't know that, you probably know that anyway, but Angelina's angels. And so many celebrities, they get to a point, maybe Angelina will too, I don't think so, but she might. They get to a point where they just take for granted that, the place is going to get sold out and they're going to, yada, yada. But, Angelina appreciates all the little things and the big things and all the people involved. So that's a special person right there. Let's go ahead and watch this last one here. It's not real long. It doesn't have Angelina singing. It's just a picture of her face, but that's probably enough. Let's go ahead and watch it.
There's so many ways I want to say I love you. Let me hold you in my arms forevermore. You have There's so many ways I want to say I love you. Let me hold you in my arms forevermore. You have gone and made. There's so many ways I.
Okay, so I thought I'd just put that in there because to me, getting a chance to see, you know, this to me looks like a, well, you could say it's a planned thing, but so much of life nowadays is captured on cell phones impromptu. You know, you just kind of whip out your phone and take a picture, right? Or a video or whatever it might be. So they caught Angelina here and, you know, an everyday, you know, not particularly exciting or interesting video, but it just shows her as a real person. That's what I like about it. And it's an unscripted capture of her as just being a person. And I like those videos a lot, because I hope for Angelina that as she becomes more famous and more popular, that she could stay attached to and tight with her family. They're always at the concerts with her. It seems like they're always there. Grandma Mary, everybody. Uncle Mike. The two little girls there were her two cousins. That's Uncle Mike's daughters, Athena and Aries. And, you know, it's being surrounded by your family and moments like this when you're rising in popularity and celebrity, I think that's critical. I really do. I think it's critical to keep a person grounded and based and, you know, keep them in touch with where they came from, who they are, you know, as a person. Because it's probably pretty easy to get caught up in the money, the fame, the adoration, you know, all that stuff. So, thank you for watching the video. Thanks for watching the first one with me, because that was my first time watching it. And I haven't seen the one, this backstage one at the concert. I haven't watched the whole thing. I watched just the first few seconds of it when it first came out, but I never got back to it, unfortunately, because that's quite a interesting and emotional look at all the stuff that goes on prior to and up, leading up to and during and after the concert. So, anyway, we will see all you guys in the next video. Have a great day. Go out and make it happen. It's up to you. Bye-bye.